So welcome to the TNT News. Here in this little video blog, I'm Mike American. And I want to say today, I'm not working at 14 decades, and it's always good to have you on with the guys from the 70s. I'm Glenn Brown. I'm just a guy who wants to talk about stuff. So I want to tell you a few things that you can get out to be a climax and stuff together. I'll tell you about things. And, you know, the reality is, these were both good sports. You know, the reality of it, that it, you know, I want to say this is polite, but it's like, you and I have some friends, or at least five serious friends, okay, who basically want to keep the war going. They want to be on one side of the other, of the means of communicating terms. And why that's where eventually no sense. And there are cases to be made that one pass is not looking up to the world up to that path. So there's valid reasons to have these issues with problems. But the truth of the matter is when you look at the groups, you look at OFDN, the way they manage frequency, or you look at Lima, the way they manage attendance, right? All that stuff comes from Wi-Fi. Okay? And Broadcast 4BWE talks a lot about the fact that we can make a case that Wi-Fi is really what 4G is going to be. Because Wi-Fi needs guidelines. Knowing the guidelines is a part of our life. But the reality is that Wi-Fi has to be a property that we don't talk about. That Broadcast is a code that was installed on. All that chip processing power, right, is actually being very well figured out. You might be able to be instead of the Wi-Fi and what's coming out of big companies like Intel or Facebook. So there's actually a case of saying that the throughput processing is going to be safe on those kinds of services. And we're very excited about 5 gigahertz for Wi-Fi. It feels like that's going to be a great spectrum for short time. Well, the FCC is talking about it for the next 3 years. So it's easier future, but the reality is, you know, it's the FCC side that has problems. Right, that's the same. However, we've got this interesting problem on the FCC side. When you listen to what they're really talking about, someone's talking about the 100 megabit, although that generates part of the standard case, right? They're all on the market side of the where it's probably going to be 11 to 12 megabits. Guys like Bitcoin's that has lies to tell you that's going to be fine. And, you know, that's the 64,000 probably has a contract for them. Or be honest, 4G terrestrial is terrible. And mobile is 100 megabits. Okay? That's the problem. I can't know that, right? But the reality is that Verizon is dealing with LTE with a bit of files, which is they're going to deal with a lot of emergency stages. You know, they're going to be a leader, they're going to drive the marketplace. But the truth of the matter is, they're running ahead of the chipsets. So we've got issues like our powers like Epson Optics, Frank, and those guys, right? You're going to see them basically having to get the chipsets as quick as possible. But it's not going to have quite all the standard specs figured out yet. We're going to have problems with a lot of building problems over the next 2 to 3 years. So, LTE is going to want to get your loyalty rate to your carrier, you're going to want to be on it. But if you're sitting there and you're moving from one carrier to another, the odds that it's going to be fully functional and operable is probably not as strong as you expected. And that was previously said. TSM was built interoperability, right? They all signed memorandum of understanding that made it so that you could roam on it, right? So you wouldn't try to go here and go to here. You just get to choose the carrier, right? You're not going to be at that stage where that was a need for a while. I'm assuming that both those and not the book will be deployed. What would be going on then? Possibly those that have happened. These are the topics that I listen to and that I care about. I listen to the carriers all the time talking about this stuff. And I keep asking myself the question, okay, when, how, who, where do we make money? What's the right next evolution for? I mean, I don't know if it's time to do that. What are we going to do? usually look at anything is that you've got IPX built early on, you've got enterprise customers, you've got great software experience, enterprise people, you've got app developers going on, you've got smart grid stuff going on at the core. It's got so much there, right? And I look at the whole thing and just purpose the part of the content of people so that it's available. There are a lot of other events going on, there are a lot of other events that are going on, but we are really focused.